Our next speaker in favour of the resolution is Gavin Newlands MP, to be followed by Jean Freeman. Please welcome one of our new MPs, my MP, Gavin Newlands.
Thanks very much, Derek, and can I congratulate you on finishing top of the West of Scotland list for the upcoming Scottish Parliament elections as well. Yeah, I'd very much welcome the opportunity to take part in this very important resolution. There's not many more important resolutions that we passed this weekend. There's no doubt that this party and our Scottish Government have made massive strides in this area in the last few years. The commitment on 50-50 representation on boards, best exemplified by our fantastic gender balance cabinet, a Europe-leading movement on reducing female unemployment, and our groundbreaking plans for childcare in this country, all designed to allow women as much access to the job market as men. These are all commendable and wonderful initiatives, and we should applaud them. However, I want to speak to the section of the resolution that deals with violence against women. It's disappointing, to say the least, that in 2015 we're still having to talk about any of this, but in particular it's quite frankly ridiculous that we're still having to campaign for the end of male violence against women. No matter how frustrated you get, no matter how angry you might be, there's never, never any excuse whatsoever for hitting a woman. This is behaviour that we should all speak out against, challenging violence in whatever form it takes. In conference, it's time that we all say enough is enough. That's why I recently supported the White Ribbon campaign, which is a movement by men, for men, active in over 60 countries, challenging men to take responsibility for the issue, which aims to end the scourge of violence against women. I tabled an early day motion in Parliament backing the White Ribbon campaign, which has received widespread support, and which notes that 45% of women in this country have experienced some form of domestic violence, sexual assault or stalking. 45%. I'm delighted that Clare's Law has been rolled out across Scotland. Clare's Law is a scheme which allows people to be told if their partner has been violent in the past, and is needed now more than ever. Conference, we're making progress in a lot of areas mentioned in this motion. However, as a man and as a Scot, I'm ashamed to say that the number of domestic abuse incidents actually rose in Scotland last year. There were nearly 60,000 incidents reported to the police this last year, an increase of over 1,000. Domestic violence is the issue that nobody wants to talk about. It's the elephant in the room. Of course, not all violence is physical. The scars left by mental bullying can at times last longer and have a bigger impact. Abuse, both physical and mental, is about power. The uncomfortable truth is that far, far too many men still think that they are the boss. Relationships only last if they're a partnership of equals, and we must do more to help address controlling behaviours in men through education and shining a light on areas such as this. We should not be afraid to talk about our shortcomings. We can, we must, we will do better. As a father of two young daughters, it's not a world I want my girls to grow up living in. I pledge never to commit, condone or remain silent about men's violence against women in all its forms, and urge you to pass this resolution. Thanks very much,
Gavin.